What are you looking at, baby?
Keto fish pie.
Not more recipes?
Yes.
We're going to start doing some recipes, aren't we?
Yes.
Come on, Shell. You won't have to be in them. It'll all be done on the worktop. We'll tell you about that in a second.
Oh, that'd be great then.
Well, hello, folks, to another Butler's Empire video where we haven't done too much this week. I've been working on the TGB moped, Sharon. And what have you been up to? Let's tell the people what you've been up to.
I don't know.
Eh?
Clearing rooms. Decorating's going to be taking place upstairs.
Yeah, well, they know all about that. We've told them about that. That's the bathroom upstairs, which we're working in. And I've been working on the TGB moped. We're starting to put the engine back together now, which you'll probably see if you pop over to Retro Restore, Sharon.
Yes.
Yes. And also, I've been buying some more stuff, haven't I?
Yes.
For our new videos.
Yes. A
lot of people ask us, Shell, they say, oh, can we do some more cooking videos? Well, we're going to be doing little short videos. As you predominantly know, that we mostly eat ketogenic food. She's got a keto book there. That's for a slow cook. That's for the slow cooker?
Yeah, but I don't do everything.
Oh, crow, cook. That's better. Go on, off you go.
Yeah, but I don't do everything in the slow cooker.
No, but we eat predominantly, we're very low carb. If it's not fully keto, it's very low carb anyway. So, yes, we're going to be doing some quick, snappy keto recipes where, well, basically you can, it'll be about 2 to 3 minutes long maximum. So, them sort of videos. You know, you've probably seen them on the Facebook or whatever where they do them quick videos, overhead shots and all that.
I must say, found a new one.
What, found a new
peanut
what?
Peanut butter bread.
Yeah, yeah, that's not bad.
Well, that takes seconds to make.
Does it?
The longest bit is mixing it together.
Well, that's not going to be much of a video, is it, if it only takes seconds to make, Sharon?
It does. It's three ingredients.
Yeah. So anyway, we're now in February. Mid-February? 13th of February, well, when we're filming this. And obviously, over the Christmas period, we both put on a bit of weight. We ate a few things that we shouldn't have eaten, sort of thing. And anyway, this week I've just jumped on the scales and I'm now reversing it again. I've been not strict keto, but I do mostly no carbs, so to speak, or low, very, very low carb. If we do have any carbs at all, it's root vegetables, Sharon, isn't it?
Yeah.
Which you shouldn't really eat on a keto diet, but we treat ourselves.
You can have celeriac, that's a root vegetable.
Yeah, that's a, but it's still got more carbs in than leafy vegetables, let's say. But if you want to lose weight, if you want to cut out...
Stop eating.
Well, no, that's not quite right though, baby, is it? Because we eat plenty of food and you've always commented on how much I pile up on my plates, basically. So it's not about stop eating or making restricting yourself. I actually eat plenty of food and I'm not hungry in between meals. And if we are hungry in the evening, for example, as I've said to you before, we have little snacks, there's certain snacks we have. So you haven't got to starve yourself and restrict yourself. And it's no good saying, oh, I can still have a slice of this or a bit of that because everything's all right in moderation. No, not when you're bleating overweight, it ain't, because 9 times out of 10, as I said before, you're addicted to food and you don't really know it. And you only know that you're addicted to it if you're craving it. And we don't really have cravings anymore. But if we do have cravings, there are little things we can have, which I think we've shown them before, Shell, like our zero-calorie jellies and stuff like that. And we've got the odd bowl of peanuts, for example. We don't go too mad with them anyway, but...
cheese crisps are good.
The cheese crisps are fantastic, yeah. So we'll be showing all that in,
well,
in our
seen
little...
seen the cheese crisps, haven't they?
Yeah, well, in our little cooking videos. Anyway, so what we've had to do, we've had to stop work on the bathroom upstairs because I need to get the floorboards up. And those floorboards upstairs are tongue and groove. They're sort of slotted together. And a couple of them are rotted away under where the old shower used to be. And the people who run the piping in underneath, I can't just cut through the floorboards because they've run the pipes right underneath where the floorboard is. So I've needed to buy a special tool. Not necessary to buy the special tool, but I bought it. I used to cut floorboards with what you call a floorboard saw with a curved end on it and go from the surface. But them days are gone now. That was the 80s and the 70s, Sharon.
Well, you haven't got one of them.
Well, I haven't got one, no, but I went out and bought one of these instead. Let me show you. Now, I'm showing you a tool here, and you might look interested, baby. You don't look very interested. Well, because it's a lovely tool, Sharon.
No, it's not.
It's one of those oscillating saws that you buy. I'm going to do an unboxing video on this, although I will show you it at the moment. I'm not going to take it out of the packaging. But it's one of those saws where you put bits on. Oh, let me take it out of the bag, look. Wait there. Let me go. They've got some spare blades in there, but... yeah, open that up, Sharon. Open the box up. Have you guessed what's in the box? So, yeah, this is battery operated, and I didn't get one purposely with a battery. I wanted to keep the price down because I've already got my power drills, which hurt me DeWalt power drawers, which I'm hoping these batteries will be the same. If not, I've got to buy a new battery for it. And all you do, you buy these blades for them. They come with a couple of spares. I've already bought a load of these blades, basically. So, oh, you've got to get it out of the package here. That's all right. Keep that, because I've got to put this back in the packet, you see. And all you do, the reason why I chose this one, you put these little blades on. It's a quick release, apparently. And you just put that in there like that, I think. That's the wrong way around. Would help if I read the instructions, wouldn't it? Mm. Well, it's the first time I've opened it, Shell.
Yeah, and get on with it.
Well, get on with it. And that's it. That little blade, you can then plunge that into wood or even metal, because they do a metal blade as well. It's very noisy, that's what I will say. I've seen people use them and say they're very, very noisy. But they allow you to get into corners. Let's say, for example, I can't make a demonstration, shall I? Well, anyway, if you've got to cut through something where you can't physically get a saw in, you can plunge this in. This oscillates, and it literally cuts through like the floorboard or whatever.
What, that bit there cut?
Yeah, that little blade, that's it.
All right.
And that will get you in any, and that saves you having to do that and try and get in there. Because I need to plunge down, because I can't cut the normal conventional way. One, because I can't get a blinking saw in there. And two, the pipes are right underneath the floorboard. So that's what I'll be doing a review on. This is the XR brushless. I went for the brushless ones. Apparently, they're supposed to be a lot better as well. This weren't too bad. This was...
97.
Was it £97? It's yep. The DCS355 oscillating blade. And all you do, as I say, literally, push that thing in. And then you lift the blade out that way. And that's it. But I'll put that back in the bag, baby. I'll be doing a review on that. But to do a review, rather than have funny camera angles and stuff like that, I've bought a new tripod, so to speak. I mean, I've got over it in the past when we do close-up shots on this workshop and all that, but I thought we needed a bit more... Yeah, put a book in, okay. A bit more... That's not how it came, was it? We'll have to do that later, baby.
Just give a seat.
Oh, go on then. I'll get me pole in. So I've actually bought...
What's that?
This pole, which... You can bolt onto a worktop, and it's really sturdy, like that. There we go. And I've bought this extra couple of things with it. This is a swivel or ball head, which you can do at any angle like that, as you can see. And also the mobile phone bracket. Oh, so coming in here with my mobile phone, so you can clamp your phone in here. They make different types of these brackets, but you just then you tighten that down. Like that, and then you can move this arm about. You can drop that through 90 degrees, as you can see, like that, so you can have that directly over your worktop. Now, we've got shadows here at the moment because obviously I've got the lighting set up for us vertically. But what we do, we'd have two lights coming in there at 45 degree angles, and maybe one at the front there, and that gives us the ability to film. If I draw my line with my fingers, oh, I can put that on wide. Put that on wide. With this P30 Pro, you've got a wide angle as well. But I can come out to there. I'm just looking down the lens there. There, and there, all the way down there, right to the end there. So that's my work area. And what we'll do, we'll have different types of backgrounds where we can illuminate the different types of... What am I saying, Shell? The backgrounds I've bought, and I bought little backgrounds.
Oh, backgrounds. You have different.
Yeah, but we don't want. This is a bit boring and bit sort of grey and a bit reflective as well.
Best to get me new kitchen worktop sensor.
No, we
boring.
Don't need to, babe, because I've only got to do that much. So we've got some special backgrounds coming of like, oh, you can even make them. Get some floorboards or whatever, stain them or whatever. So you can make them, but you can actually buy backgrounds in a sheet. But this is so much more better because you can move this about as well if you want to change the shot, for example. That goes up and down. If I'm doing a product review, you say you can move the angles about, you can come in from a different angle like that. If I wanted to get a sort of an angle, different angle view of it sort of thing. There we go, like that. So yeah, you can come in at different angles, but also it's so sturdy and you haven't got all the vibration and bumping about and all. Look, look, I can do all that. Look, huh? So that's another thing. That's quite expensive, that. I can't remember how much that was, Sharon. But again, these little things you really need if you're going to be looking, doing a sort of a professional sort of filming and whatever. But that's like the lights we've got here, for example. We've only got two of these. Do you want to pull one of them lights over, Sharon? Just so they can see what these lights are. So these, again, are LED. Oh, not on my face, baby. These are LED lights. And again, these have got a rotating swivel base, for example. So we can even use these there. These would probably be fine, actually. So I could do that there and have the other one, which I've got over there, facing down there. So there, move that straight, for example. Move that ball so that's round like that. And then I can film, and that'll, in fact, that's great, Sharon.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah,
lovely.
That's great. So there we go. These don't come into view because they're out of shot sort of thing. So you can even swivel them any angle you want sort of thing. So yeah, that's out of shot now. So look, two of them, I could have one there and one coming down there. Hey presto, Bob's your mother's brother. You like it?
I love it.
Yeah, so
I
that's
absolutely
it.
Love
so
it.
All your set is, literally, is here. So if you ever got to do any tabletop stuff, I mean, you can do it on a tripod. We used to do it on a tripod, but you get the legs that are in the way sort of thing, you know? So this, you've got, you can, sort of this arm, you could probably easily extend that arm as well, but you don't really need to, Shao, because you can have that in many different positions or whatever, look. And having the ball head on it.
Is it extendable though, that arm?
No, that's not. No, you got, but you can make another one in brackets and have a longer one or whatever if you needed to come in from a wider angle. But yeah, that's just the sort of thing we do. What we have done before is we've just put sort of two mini tripods here and had a bar going across the top, and that works as well. But sometimes you can have all this setting up and all that. Well, all I've got to do here is just literally undo a clamp like this. And then that's it, it's gone. Look, off.
I wish somebody could make that, couldn't you? When you look at
yeah, but you can make it. You can.
Scaffolding pole.
Well, yeah, well, a scaffolding pole, Jay. You can buy a pole. You can make all this stuff. But it's how much time do you want to invest in making it, basically, you know?
We can make a video on making it. There you go.
Let's put that back over there, look. That's back. Got to be able to see your beautiful face, baby. So, yeah, that's what we've been doing. Don't forget, if you want to send your stickers off to our sticker wall, we've had a few people get in contact with us and they'd like our stickers. And also, don't forget, you can put your stickers on our wall. Just send me an email. And someone said they couldn't find our email address on our YouTube channel. Well, they are on there. As I said before, if you go to our About page, let's say, for example, on Butler's Empire, go to our About page, and then there's a bit that says Details or Description and then Details. And in that Details section on our About page, it says,
click on it, didn't
it? It says, for business inquiries, click here for email address. Then you click there and you can find it. But apparently he was trying to find it on his phone. Whether or not you can see that on a phone, I don't know. So that's where you need to send us your address so that we can send you our stickers. So yeah, well done, baby. So look forward to doing them videos. So I keep going to put my tea in my mouth, Sharon.
No, you don't stop, do you?
Anyway, so yeah, that's what we've been doing. So we're back on it again now. As I said, we're over the Christmas period. We've not gone mad. In fact, no, we haven't gone mad, Sharon. We just started eating carbs.
It all started really from holiday.
It all started, Sharon, when I had bleeding 3 months of constant pain when I had shingles first. And directly after that, when I had that for about 6 weeks, I got that bleeding arm pain, didn't I?
I went through hell.
You went through hell, Sharon. 3 months of solid pain I was in, baby.
Gap in the night, I can't sleep. Well, neither can I now.
Eh?
You'd wake me up in the night.
You're there to help me, baby. Eh?
Bad enough the dog gets me up every night.
Have you got anything you want to tell him? About things you've been doing or what you've been up to?
No, I just said that I've been preparing upstairs, haven't I, for decorating.
Do you want to show him your wallpaper? Go and show him your wallpaper.
No, I'm interested.
I'll let her do the papering in the house, yeah?
I love it.
I know. I've spent, obviously, years and years since the age of blinking, 17, 18, whatever, doing wallpapering in the house and all that. And over the last few years, she wanted to have a go, and I've let her do it.
But I love it.
Come and show us. She's been buying new wallpaper. Where's this for?
This is for the bedroom upstairs, which I've already got in the dining room.
Right.
It's me bunny rabbits and hedgehogs.
They're not going to be able to see it. What's the name of it? Would they be able to look it up online, wouldn't they?
It's beautiful.
Is it called Statement Feature Wallpaper?
And I think I'm going to have grey painted walls, maybe.
So yellow and grey, okay, yeah, fair enough.
That looks really nice.
Right, and what's
and
that?
This is for my ironing room.
Which is in there where you've seen
her. You'll see it all when it's done. This is
checked.
Mushroom colour, which I quite like.
Well, there won't be mushroom in there, will there?
No.
And one thing I have noticed, Sharon, there's two rolls of paper there. Wait there. I found this bit of paper on the workshop just as I was cleaning up. Right, what's this? Hold on. And it says, 3 rolls of wallpaper, £30. So it's £10 a roll.
Yeah.
Is that good?
No, actually, I found this one for £8.99 a roll. Everywhere else was £12. I really searched for things, and it was the delivery charge that brought up to that.
Right, okay.
This is cheap wallpaper, actually.
Is it? I don't know, Sharon.
Wallpaper starts from like £15 upwards.
Back in the
I even see wallpaper for £45 a roll.
Back in the 25 years ago, maybe.
Did you think that was a lot then, love?
The dearest wallpaper... Well, I thought... No, in actual fact, I didn't look properly, Sharon. I thought that was for one roll. When I opened it, I've only just saw that it said three rolls. I just saw yellow wallpaper, and I've only ever seen... Did you get three rolls of that?
Yeah, three rolls.
Well, I've only seen the one roll.
They're in the box. No, because I was sitting...
So I'll come here to give you a little bit of a pasting, and I've clocked the number three next to it, so I can't do that now. You'll have to slap my wrist, baby.
I am very conscious when I buy. I'm not tight, don't get me wrong, but if I can find it cheaper somewhere else, I will do.
Yeah.
And well, I actually think this is a little company I've got it from.
Yeah.
A home business, right. Not a big commercial
place. We would rather go to a little company, yeah. A little one-man band, not a one-man band, but a little family business or whatever, than go to the big branded places, because we like to support... Yeah. The little companies, don't we, baby?
Now, I've got my colour charts, but I will now go take my colour that I want and I will take it down to the hardware and they mix it on their machine for me. Rather than go somewhere like B&Q and give them the money, I'll give it to the village, the hardware.
We always use our little hardware shop in the village. We've got two, there's two of them there, but one, it's like it used to be years ago where... I know, well, I say there's only one bloke in there at the moment. There's only allowed to be one bloke in there, isn't there? But anyway.
Well, before there was only
but he
two,
knows exactly
there?
What his stock is. And it's one of those hardware shops where you've got, they've got everything. You ask them what, if you can't see it, ask them. And he goes running out the back and he'll come back with it. And that is Goodwin's in the village, Sharon, isn't
very,
it?
Very good.
Ashley, behind the jump. He's a young chap behind a jump. I've known him for quite a long time now.
And if they haven't got it, he'll try his hardest to get it.
Yeah, because they've got another branch about 6 miles away. And they do, well, if we ain't got it, he said, we'll have it here by 2 o'clock this afternoon.
Yeah, fantastic.
But they shout at one, shall?
That's on a Saturday.
That's a joke, shall. Comedy. I do comedy, shall.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we support our little shops and all that. And, I urge you to do the same because the big boys...
Especially now.
The big boys knock the little boys out of the park. And it's just like in a school playground. On. The big boys always win, Sharon.
The little shops need our support now.
Of course they do. Anyway.
More than ever.
Watch out. I'm going to take them outside now. I'm going to brave that cold. And
it's bitter out there.
I love the snow, right? I love the snow. But after about 3 or 4 days, when it gets cold at night and then
it's ice now,
and then it freezes, I hate that. Yeah?
I heard somewhere...
You've got to cut that bit of air, Sharon. Can I do it now?
No, because we haven't got the right scissors.
Sharon?
Don't do it with any scissors, no. Tracy!
Come on. Where are they?
I heard the River Thames was frozen.
No, it's not been... Okay. Last time that froze was 1963.
That's exactly what
63, the year I was
part
born.
Part of the River Thames was frozen. I meant to tell you that.
Yeah, well, you've told me, Sharon.
Do you know what? I'm not going to tell you nothing
You
anymore.
Tell me everything, baby. Yeah? Yeah.
Watch was this space, people.
Was there a lot of roll, Sharon?
Crusty roll.
Crusty roll, yeah. We do love a crusty roll.
That is what I do. Crusty bread. That's
yeah, but...
You forget about it after, but you know sometimes you get, oh, it's a nice crusty bacon roll, but then I have something that you forget about it.
A crusty roll or, I'll tell you what we had the other day, I'll be honest with you, we had a bacon sandwich, but it was on, what's it called, a no gluten free bread?
Gluten free bread.
And it's only because we had a good day that day, didn't we, for some reason? And, hello.
And it was on offer.
Yeah, but we had a good day and we treated ourselves.
Do
we
know
had,
what?
We had
a
bacon sandwich.
I feel sorry for the people that need to buy gluten-free stuff because, my God, it's expensive.
And it's also bland, Sharon.
Mm.
It's like bloody fools. You go to butter the gluten-free bread. Not that we had bread, as I said, but we did on one day. It falls apart. Yeah. What's that about?
It doesn't help that our butter's hard because we like hard butter, not like... I don't like soft butter. I like to taste the butter.
You cake it on, baby. When we do
get
our...
on keto, you can have butter.
You can have keto, yeah. Oh, what did you see on the telly today? What did they say?
My brother was saying about he's read somewhere that 3 eggs a day or a week is bad for you.
3 eggs a week, you said, is bad for you.
Was it a week?
What a load of rubbish.
They're saying that the yellow of the in the egg, it's much too high for your body and all that, and you'll die young and you'll get cancer and all that.
Oh my God! Listen, cholesterol in your blood gets there. You'll die without cholesterol. You need cholesterol in your body. Your body makes cholesterol, but if you get excess cholesterol, yes, that's the problem. But you only get excess cholesterol when you've got other problems in your body, like inflammation, because cholesterol is the band-aid or the plaster that goes into your arteries to block up the inflammation or to sort of keep the inflammation down. So if you've got inflammation or high cholesterol, That means that you've got other issues. 9 times out of 10, it's caused by inflammation within the body. 9 times out of 10, that's caused by eating too many refined carbs, or if you eat grains, too many grains or whatever, that causes internal inflammation, and then you can get excessive. So in other words, treat the cause and not the symptom.
That's right.
That's all I'm going to say. Anyway, I'm going to go outside now. Are you finished with me in here?
Yeah, I'm just looking because my granddaughter, you know, our lovely granddaughter Olivia, she's having a new bathroom put in and they've just changed her room. So Evie, my eldest granddaughter, is excited and she's sending me pictures of the new room.
Yeah.
And how happy.
That's Gary's daughter, his youngest daughter, as you know, she's palliative care. And they're doing a bit of a modernisation or moving about in their room anyway. Come on, Shao, I've got to go outside. I just want to quickly, before we finish this video, pop you outside, just show you what I'm doing on the TGB moped. I'll see you in a minute. And when I come back, baby, I'll have a nice sandwich, bacon sandwich. I'll have the full Monty.
Hang on, dream on, baby.
And I want 2 dozen eggs as well.
I don't know what to have for tea, though, Sam.
Yeah, here's the garden. Look, it's that well-trodden down now, and this is all rock hard now. It's not nice and soft anymore, so it's a bit horrible, actually. What's the matter, mate? He wants to come out, doesn't he? Oh, I can't wait to get all this sorted out, get all this started. I want this all sort of finished this year, definitely, anyway. Yeah, it's very cold and dank out here. Oh, cold in here. Woof, that's coming here. Turn that light off. Right, what are we up here? Cool, that's how cold it is. Look, it's about 2.5-3 degrees, look. There's the old sticker wall there with a few of my new stickers on there. Steve the Transit Camp is one of the new ones up there, as you know. Yeah, there you go. If you want a sticker on there, don't forget, just send me an email and I'll put it on there. So let's come through to the back. Now you're seeing, as I say, as and when I do work sort of thing, you know. So this work, the video on this one may not even be out yet, but as you can see, I've got the engine so-called back together now. I've got to get a reed valve gasket for that, if I remember rightly, but I might end up making that, so playing by ear. I've done the powder coating on the casing over there. Someone said you can fix that with JB Weld, which I'm aware of, but I didn't really want to bother. It's not a restoration job. If I was doing a restoration job, I would have filled all the pitting on that with the heat filler I've got, but I wasn't too bothered. It looks 100% better than what it was, basically, so I'm happy with that anyway. So yeah, that's all in the process. I'm working on that as we go, and that's the reason I had to stop yesterday. I had to repaint the again, that's the reed valve housing sort of thing. So yeah, as what I'm finding is that when I put this stuff away many years ago, I just sort of dumped it in the box. That was the old crank there. Look, can you see where it's broken? Look, that's where the crank was actually broken, look, in half. And that caused the actual initial problem sort of thing, look. God knows how that was like that, look. Snapped it. And where it's been rubbing smooth, I don't know if it was like that for a while, but yeah, that was the old crank. But I'm refurbishing bits as we go along. I've got to clean up nuts and bolts and stuff like that. There's the old variator over there. All this sort of stuff there. That's the old barrel, by the way. And I think this is a 60 or 70cc set. But that would have all been installed at the moment, but I had to paint the it's not in that oven, is it? It's in this one. I had to paint the engine barrel and head yesterday with heat proof paint, and as you can see there now, it's now gone off. I baked it on as well, so this was okay because this was brand new so many years ago. It was sort of rusted on the edges because it was bare cast basically, so I had to paint all this with heat proof paint. So that's the cylinder head as well. So there we go, that's all been done. So I can now reassemble that, but that will be coming up in a video which I'm working on at the moment. So yeah, there we go. That's what I'm up to in here. Anyway, well, I hope you've enjoyed it. Not much in this video, but I'm just showing you some up and coming stuff we got going on behind the scenes, which is all what Butler's Empire is about. And also, as you know, Sharon appears in the Butler's Empire videos, and quite a lot of you like to see Sharon as opposed to see me. Anyway, don't forget, if you do like our channel, hit the subscribe button below, ring that little notification bell down there and set your preferences to all, and that way you'll get notified every time we upload a video. Do check out my other channels, Retro Restore and also Retro Hacks. I'm not too sure where I'm going to be putting the cooking videos yet. We have got a selection of cooking videos on Retro Hacks under our vintage cooking, where we went back and we've done some vintage cooking from years and years ago. So we have got some cooking videos on there. These will be purely keto meals and also very low carb meals if you want to enjoy a low carb way of life and improve your health, believe it or not. That's what I feel it does, as it has done to me. And I'm not sure where I'll be putting them yet, but keep watching, keep tuning into our other channels because they could pop up anywhere. Anyway, thanks very much. Hope you've enjoyed this video and I'll see you in the next video. And until then, Bye for now.